Hello and welcome. This is Chandni Nebnani and you are watching It's Tomorrow News. Storm Dennis, anger and fear across UK as second storm breaks. Storm Dennis has wreaked havoc on Britain, forcing the cancellation of hundreds of flights and trains and the deaths of at least two people yesterday. As the so-called bomb cyclone battered the coastline, as much as months worth of rainfall was predicted overnight and into Sunday morning in some parts of the UK. The worst effects were felt at sea with two bodies pulled from the waters off the Kent coast. One man was found off Herne Bay and declared dead at the scene, while another lost his life after falling from an oil tanker. His body was found near Margate. Inland, many parts of the country had been recovering from Storm Sierra last weekend, which flooded 800 homes and left 500,000 people without electricity. The latest assault by the weather was forcing clean-up operations to stop. Energy firms were battling to restore power to dozens of areas. At 11 p.m. last night, Britain's six power networks were reporting power cuts in 299 areas, with 107 in Scotland. EasyJet has cancelled more than 60 flights due to depart on Sunday. Most on its route to Geneva as well as to Spain, Portugal and the Canary Islands. For many passengers, the misery was compounded by their inability to book seats on replacement flights. Flooding was already affecting some areas on Saturday. In Kandal, Cumbria, roads were impassable and railway tracks were flooded near Newquay, Manchester, Crewe, Kern, Ebe Valley, Windermere, Barrow, Inverness and Carsill, with several other line closures due to fallen trees. On Saturday, 75 soldiers and 70 reservists were sent to West Yorkshire to support the recovery and bolster preparations for the incoming storm. The Environment Agency predicted flooding would be worse than last weekend as the ground is already saturated. Across Yorkshire, which gets an average 51 to 67 millimetres of rainfall in February, forecasters predicted there would be up to 80 millimetres of rain in just 48 hours. Rail replacement buses were offered on some routes, while National Rail put speed restrictions in place on certain lines for passengers' safety. It urged people to check for updates before they began any travel. That's all for now. For more news updates, stay tuned with us. It's Tomorrow News, Chandni Nebnani. For more weather updates, do like, share and subscribe our channel.